Good morning. This is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. Today I will talk about the special features of the bones of the shoulder girdle, which are the clavicle anterior and the scapula posterior. Start by the clavicle. The clavicle is a long bone. It is formed of two ends and shaft. The two ends are medial end and lateral end. The medial end is called the sternal end because it articulates with the sternum. The lateral end is called acromial end because it articulates with the acromion. The shaft. The shaft is divided into medial two-thirds and the lateral one-third. The medial two-thirds are convex anterior. The lateral one-third is convex posterior. The weakest point of the clavicle is the junction between the medial two-thirds and the lateral one-third. That is why the common site of clavicle fracture is the middle third of the clavicle. The clavicle, the shaft, has four surfaces, upper surface and lower surface, anterior and posterior. Again, this is the clavicle. This is the medial end. This is the lateral end. External end and acromial end. The medial end articulates with the manubrium to form the sternoclavicular joint, which is a saddle synovial joint. The lateral end articulates with the acromion to form the acromioclavicular joint, which is a plane synovial joint. The shaft. The shaft is divided into medial two-thirds and lateral one-third. The medial two-thirds are convex anterior. The lateral one-third is convex posterior. Four surfaces, upper surface and lower surface, anterior surface and posterior surface. What are the muscles attached to the sternum? Muscles attached to the sternum are, first one, pectoralis major attached to the anterior surface, medial half of the anterior surface. Sternomastoid, upper surface, medial third of the upper surface. Subclavius into the inferior surface groove for the subclavius. And then deltoid, anterior border of the lateral third, and the trapezius, the posterior border of the lateral third. So the muscles attached to the sternum. Pectoralis major, anterior surface. Sternomastoid, upper surface. Subclavius, inferior surface. Deltoid, anterior border of the lateral third. Trapezius, posterior border of the lateral third. What are the ligaments attached to the clavicle? Okay, the first ligament is the costoclavicular ligament. This costoclavicular ligament is attached to an impression on the medial third of the inferior surface. Costoclavicular ligament between the clavicle and the first costal cartilage. Second ligament is the coracoclavicular ligament. This coracoclavicular ligament is formed of two parts, conoid ligament and trapezoid ligament. This is the conoid tubercle, which gives attachment to the conoid ligament, and this is the trapezoid line, gives attachment to trapezoid ligament. Conoid ligament, trapezoid ligament. The third ligament is this one, coracoacromial ligament, and ligaments of the acromioclavicular joint and sternoclavicular joint. Articulations of the clavicle. The medial end. The medial end articulates with the manubrium, okay, to form the sternoclavicular joint. What is the type of this joint? It is saddle synovial joint. The lateral end articulates with the acromion to form acromioclavicular joint. What is the type of this joint? It is plane synovial joint. What are the functions of the clavicle? The clavicle connects the upper limb to the axial skeleton, to the trunk, so it supports the upper limb. It transmits forces from the upper limb to the axial skeleton, and it gives attachment to muscles. differences between the clavicle and the other long bones. Five differences. First one, the clavicle lies horizontally. The clavicle has no medullary cavity. The clavicle is the first bone to ossify in the fetal life. It ossifies in membrane, membranous ossification, and it is a commonly fractured bone. So the five differences between the clavicle and the other bones, it lies horizontally, it has no medullary cavity, it is the first bone to ossify, it ossifies during the fifth week of intrauterine life, it ossifies in membrane, and it is a commonly fractured bone. Regarding the clavicle fracture, this is normal clavicle, okay? And this is the acromioclavicular joint, this is the acromion, and this is the coracoid process. So this is the normal clavicle. This is clavicle fracture. So what is the commonest site of clavicle fracture? The commonest site is the middle third. Why the middle third? Because it is the weakest point. After fracture, there is displacement of the medial segment and the lateral segment. The medial segment is pulled upward by the sternomastoid. The lateral segment is pulled downward by the gravity, by the weight of the upper limb. So, drop shoulder. So, clavicle fracture. The commonest site is the middle third. It is the weakest point. The medial fragment is pulled upward by the sternomastoid. The lateral fragment is pulled downward by the gravity, by the weight of the upper limb. Regarding the scapula has three angles, three borders, three fossae, and three processes. The three angles, superior angle, inferior angle, and lateral angle. The superior angle lies opposite the second rib. The inferior angle lies opposite the seventh rib. The lateral angle has three features. The first feature is the glenoid cavity. This glenoid cavity articulates with the head of the humerus to form the shoulder joint. Second feature, it has two tubercles, supraglenoid tubercle and infraglenoid tubercle for muscle attachment. Three borders, upper border, medial border, and lateral border. The upper border is the shortest and has notch. It's called the suprascapular notch. It is transformed to foramen by suprascapular ligament. The medial border is vertical. It's called vertebral border. The lateral border is called the axillary border. Three fossae, one above the spine, supraspinous fossa, one below the spine, infraspinous fossa, and one on the anterior surface, subscapular fossa. So supraspinous fossa, infraspinous fossa, and the subscapular fossa. Three processes, spine, this is the spine. And the dorsal surface of the spine is called the crest. Then acromion and the coracoid process. So acromion, coracoid process, and the spine. The crest of the spine lies opposite T3 spine, the third thoracic spine. Again, this is the dorsal surface of the scapula. This is the anterior surface of the scapula. Three angles, superior angle, inferior angle, lateral angle. Superior angle is opposite the second rib. Inferior angle opposite the seventh rib. Lateral angle has glenoid cavity for articulation with the head of the humerus, supraglenoid tubercle, and infraglenoid tubercle. Three borders, upper border, medial border, lateral border. The upper border has notch, suprascapular notch. The medial border is called vertebral border. The lateral border is called axillary border. Three processes. This is the spine. And the dorsal, the posterior border of the spine is called the crest of the spine. Then acromion and coracoid process. Okay? What are the muscles attached to the scapula? 18 muscles. 3 muscles attached to the fossae. 3 muscles attached to the lateral, to the dorsal lip of the medial border. 3 muscles attached to the dorsal lip of the lateral border, and 1 muscle attached to the ventral lip of the medial border. 3 to the fossae. This is the first one. Okay? The first one is supraspinatus. So supraspinatus to the supraspinous fossa. Infraspinatus to the infraspinous fossa. And the subscapularis to the subscapular fossa. So 3 muscles to the fossae. Supraspinatus, supraspinous fossa. Infraspinatus, infraspinous fossa. Subscapularis, subscapular fossa. Regarding the medial border, the dorsal lip gives insertion to 3 muscles. The first one, levator scapulae, from the superior angle to the crest of the spine. Then rhomboid minor, opposite the crest. Then rhomboid major, from the crest to the inferior angle. This is the lateral border or axillary border. 3 muscles. The upper 2/3, teres minor. The lower 1/3, teres major. And the inferior angle, latissimus dorsi. The back of the inferior angle. The ventral lip of the medial border, this one, gives insertion to serratus anterior. The red color is origin, the blue color is insertion. Again, muscles attached to the scapula. 2 muscles attached to the glenoid tubercles, supraglenoid tubercle and infraglenoid tubercle. Long head of biceps, supraglenoid tubercle. Long head of triceps, infraglenoid tubercle. Acromion and the spine, 2 muscles. Deltoid and trapezius. Deltoid, lateral border of the acromion and the lower border of the crest of the spine or lower lip. Trapezius, medial border of the crest or medial border of the acromion and the upper lip of the crest of the spine. 3 muscles attached to the coracoid process. To the tip, short head of biceps and coracobrachialis. To the upper surface and the medial border, pectoralis minor. And then to the upper border, small muscle here, it is the inferior belly of omohyoid. So what are the 18 muscles attached to the scapula? Okay. The 18 muscles attached to the scapula. 3 to the fossae, supraspinatus, supraspinous fossa. Infraspinatus, infraspinous fossa. Subscapularis, subscapular fossa. Dorsal lip of the medial border, levator scapulae from the upper angle to the crest, rhomboid minor opposite the crest, rhomboid major from the crest to the inferior angle. Lateral border, teres minor upper 2/3, teres major lower 1/3, and the latissimus dorsi back of the inferior angle. Serratus anterior, ventral lip of the anterior of the medial border. The glenoid tubercles, supraglenoid tubercle, long head of biceps, infraglenoid tubercle, long head of triceps, acromion and the spine, deltoid, lateral border of acromion, lower lip of the spine, trapezius, medial lip, medial border of the acromion, upper lip of the spine, 3 muscles to the coracoid process, to the tip, short head of biceps and the coracobrachialis, upper surface and the medial border, pectoralis minor, and the medial and the upper border here is inferior belly of omohyoid. What are the ligaments attached to the scapula? This is the suprascapular notch. Suprascapular notch. It is converted to foramen by this ligament, suprascapular ligament. So the first ligament is the suprascapular ligament. It converts the suprascapular notch to foramen. The suprascapular nerve passes through the foramen. The suprascapular artery passes above the suprascapular ligament. Second ligament, this one, is the coracoclavicular ligament. This coracoclavicular ligament is formed of two parts, conoid ligament and trapezoid ligament. Conoid is medial, trapezoid is lateral. And the third ligament between coracoid and acromion, it is the coracoacromial ligament to the tip of the acromion, and then glenohumeral and coracohumeral ligaments, ligaments of the shoulder joint. Okay, quiz. What is the function of the coracoclavicular ligament? It is very important ligament. This coracoclavicular ligament transmits the weight of the upper limb, okay, to the axial skeleton. So upper limb, scapula, coracoclavicular ligament, clavicle, and axial skeleton. So what is the function of coracoclavicular ligament? Transmits the weight of the upper limb to the axial skeleton. Second, what are the vertebral levels of the scapula? We have three levels. Superior angle, opposite the second thoracic spine, T2 spine or second rib. Inferior angle, opposite the seventh thoracic spine or seventh rib. The crest of the spine is opposite the third thoracic spine. Articulations of the scapula. The scapula forms two joints. This is the first joint, shoulder joint. Shoulder joint between the glenoid cavity and the head of the humerus, and it is ball and socket synovial joint. Second one, acromioclavicular joint. Between the acromion and the lateral end of the clavicle, it is plain synovial joint. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck.